and welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. For this video, we're going to work on square roots. So at first, they may seem a little bit mysterious. After all, how do you start with something like a square root of 16 and all of a sudden get 4? Well, the key to really understanding something like a square root is really understanding the squaring process. So for a moment, we're just going to take numbers and square them. When you have a number, say 3, and you square it or raise it to the power of 2, what you're really saying here is that you're taking 3 and you're multiplying it by itself. Now, the multiplication process is usually a little bit more familiar, so 3 times 3, this would give us a number like 9. And again, let's try this with another number. So 5 squared is the same as 5 times 5, which is 25. Now, if you can understand that process, square roots are going to be great. The reason is, with square roots, we're essentially working in the other direction. So when I see something like the square root of 9, I'm thinking what multiplied by itself would essentially give me a 9? Well, we already did the squaring process, so think of this as 3 squared. 9, 3 squared, same thing. Now the square and the square root will take care of each other, and we'll just be left with 3. And again, another way I can think of this is, well, the number that multiplied by itself that would give me this 9 here is the 3. All right, so let's see this process again, taking the square root of 25. Well, just like our work shows, the number that's multiplied by itself that would give us 25 is 5. There we go. So with that idea in mind, we can do many, many more types of square roots. Let's try a few more just to make sure we have down the process, and then we'll get into some more difficult ones near the end. So what number multiplied by itself would give us a 36? Hopefully this one's familiar. 6 times 6 is the same as 36. Exactly the same, looks good. So I could think of this as 6 squared. And the answer is 6. Now, you may not need to write down all of the steps after you do a bunch of these as practice, and that's okay. I'm going to continue writing down all the steps so you can see really what's working in the background. So here I have the square root of 64. 8 times 8 is equal to 64. So I can look at this as 8 squared, or the answer is just 8. All right, the numbers are getting a little bit bigger here. No worries, we'll continue on. Let's see, 49, 7 times 7. So I have the square root of 7 squared, or 7. And one more, looks like we have 100 here. Well, that's the same as 10 times 10, or 10 squared, 10. Nice. Now, some roots, you can't necessarily break them down into two nice numbers that would multiply and give you the number underneath the root. So in some of these more difficult ones, we'll have to attack them in a slightly different way, see what can come out of the root, and maybe what has to stay underneath there. Let's take the first one. If I look at 18 and I'm thinking of a number that multiplies by itself to give me 18, you know, nothing really comes to mind. After all, 4 times 4 is 16. That's too small. 5 times 5 is 25, and that's way too big. So what I know about this guy is whatever number it is, it's somewhere between 4 and 5. Now, the interesting thing is, I could break down 18 into two numbers. Let's say 9 and 2. Now, those are not the same, so I'm not done with this root just yet. But notice this 9 was actually in some of our earlier examples. That is something that we can take the square root of. And the neat part about square roots is we can split them up over multiplication. So I can think of this as two different roots. I'm looking at the square root of 9 multiplied by the square root of 2. Now this guy, we can do that guy just fine. The square root of 9 is 3, because 3 times 3 would give us that 9. So here I have a simplified square root, which is simply 3 times the square root of 2. Now, the square root of 2, I'm just going to leave as it is, because again, I can't think of two numbers exactly the same that when multiplied, that would give me that 2. So we would consider this just the simplified one. Let's try that again with another one. This one is the square root of 24. What you immediately want to do if you can't find two numbers that are the same is maybe just think of numbers that are squared numbers that do divide into 24. So I start thinking, let's see, what can I divide into 24? Oh, 4 goes in there. And 4 is a number that I can easily take the square root of. So square root of 4 multiplied by the square root of 6. Or 2 times the square root of 6. Not bad. Now, larger numbers, such as 144, sometimes you have to do a little bit of breaking down in order to figure out how to attack them using these roots. If you have a very large number, try seeing what smaller numbers will divide into it. So for example, 144, I know that's the same as 2 times 72. Okay, neither one of those are one of our squared numbers, but we can keep breaking this down. 72 is the same as 2 times 36. Now, as I break this down, I'm constantly looking for squared numbers, and I think we finally got one here. 36 is the same as 6 squared, or 6 times 6. So I can take that number, along with the other numbers we've broken it down into, and put those underneath our square root. So 2 times 2 is the same as 4. I'll take these two, and a 36. All right, so by looking at some of those smaller numbers now, I can really look at this problem as the square root of 4 and the square root of 36. And both of these aren't that bad. We've already done the square root of 4 a couple of times. This is just 2. And the square root of 36 is 6. Of course, because 6 times 6 is equal to 36. One last step, 12. So what this really means in the grand scheme of things is that when I multiply 12 by itself, 12 squared, it should equal 144. Or in the other direction, the square root of 144 is equal to 12. And there you go. That's just the basics about square roots and simplifying the more difficult ones. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit mysecretmathtutor.com.